¡Hola!
¡Hola!
¡Quita la mano!
Vale, hola otra vez.
Hola otra vez.
This is another podcast looking at some interesting verbs, and this suggestion is another suggestion from Michael. Two suggestions, Michael.
Michael, you're really busy.
Keeping us busy.
Exacto. Going to something else.
es muy mandón, Michael. Bueno, Cintia, ¿qué tal?
Muy bien.
¿Sí? Hace mucho que no te veo aquí.
Sí, hace mucho que no me ves aquí. ¿Qué tal estás tú? ¿Cuánto tiempo?
Sí, bueno, Cintia. Sí, te ha echado. Cintia, ¿qué tal estás? ¿Bien?
Sí, estoy bien.
Vale.
Vamos a hablar. ¿Qué tal estás tú?
Oh, yo no podría estar mejor.
¿Sí?
Sí. Bueno, podría, pero no quiero.
¿No quieres estar mejor?
No. Porque estoy casi al tope de ser buenísimo.
Vale. ¿Sabéis por qué Gordon no está mejor? Porque hace unos días le dije a Gordon que quería tener otro perro. Y antes teníamos un boxer y me encantan los boxers, ¿vale? Pero Gordon me dijo, boxers no. Porque perros no. Y la lista de motivos por el que no quiere tener un perro era por las babas, ¿vale? Porque Chato tenía muchas babas,
sí.
Pero bonitas, babas bonitas. Y eran bonitas.
Bueno, según tu opinión.
Eran babas de mi perro, no hay problema. Y tenía mucho pelo.
Sí.
Y pensé, vale, no quieres un boxer por las babas y por el pelo. Voy a buscar un perro hipoalergénico que no suelta pelo.
Sin babas.
Y le di una lista de perros.
Ella pasó casi un día buscando en internet.
Es que me gustan mucho los perros y a Gordon no. Excepto los chihuahuas.
Pasearlos 3 veces por día.
Me gusta.
1 hora cada vez.
Me gusta.
Lo sé.
Me gusta.
Pero yo tengo que hacerlo también.
Sí.
Mucho. Vale, ok, Cintia, ya.
Por eso no está feliz.
Stop. Stop. This is what we're talking about today. This is what we're talking about. All of the verbs to do with stop. Okay? Because...
Happy time
or hammer time?
Hammer time.
Hammer time, okay.
Or happy time, see that
okay.
Means.
Stop, yay. Happy time. All right, Cynthia, let's... Can we just look at a few
sí.
of these verbs? Okay. First of all, we've got detenerse.
Vale.
Okay? Now, that's to stop oneself, isn't it?
Detenerse.
To stop yourself.
Sí.
Okay.
Yourself or something else that stopped.
Okay, or something stops itself. Yeah?
Sí.
It's to stop oneself.
Sí.
Yeah? Okay. So, what would be the difference between detener and detenerse?
Detener would be if you stop something.
So one thing stopping another thing.
Uh-huh,
yeah?
You say, el viento detuvo... ¿Qué detuvo el viento?
Stopped the air conditioning from working.
No. Vale.
No, that would be different, wouldn't it? Yeah.
Vale. El hombre detuvo el tren.
Okay. So the man stopped the train. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Or could you say I stopped a man in the street?
Yo detuve. If you use it with a person with another person, be careful because it can be detener is what police people
detain.
Do or does the police
do?
Do. Yes.
Detain.
So if you
somebody.
Say the man detained. Detuvo al otro hombre, then I would think that he went
to prison. So how would you do it? Would you use another verb to say I stopped a man in the street?
No, it's grammatically correct to say el hombre detuvo al otro hombre. It's grammatically correct. But just in case people get confused, you can say el hombre paró al otro hombre.
Ah, okay, because we've got detener and we've got parar.
Uh-huh.
Yeah? Is there much of a difference between the two?
No.
No. So, you kind of the kind of synonym. So the
parar is the one that we commonly used
more than detener.
That's
what I hear. Is detener a bit more?
No, not much. It's just maybe parar is quicker. Yeah. Parar, detener.
Yeah.
But
and it's not irregular in preterite.
But the verb it has the verb tener in it. So if you know the verb tener, you know detener.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So
okay. So. Parar and detener is very similar in the use.
Sí.
Okay, bien. Right, so, but then we've got dejar.
Dejar o dejar de. Dejar,
dejar de.
De. Dejar de.
Which, if you look at dejar, it means to leave, yeah?
Sí, cuidado con el boli y mi camiseta blanca.
Vale. To leave, yes?
Sí.
But dejar de is to stop.
Ah, sí. Dejar de is to stop doing something or to quit doing something or...
So for example, to stop smoking.
Sí, dejar de fumar.
Dejar de fumar, okay.
And we have to remember that in Spanish, when we have a preposition, we don't use the gerund. You know, in English you say,
yes,
stop smoking.
Smoking, yeah.
And then people think, because you say smoking, we say smoking, no. With the preposition, we use in infinitive.
That's right, yeah.
So, dejar de fumar, dejar de comer hablar, chocolate, dejar de hablar, dejar de...
So, dejar de just means to stop doing something, yeah?
Stop doing something, quit doing something, sí.
Okay, all right. Could you give us, help us understand, for example, how you would say you're walking along the street and you stop?
Vale.
How would you say that?
Iba andando por la calle y me paré.
So me paré. I stopped myself. Yeah?
Sí.
Okay. And could you say me detuve?
Sí. Iba andando por la calle y me detuve.
All right.
Por ejemplo, iba andando por la calle y me detuve a ver los escaparates.
Okay. Yeah. So I was walking along the street and I stopped to look in the windows. The shop windows. The shop windows, yeah.
Sí.
Yeah. Okay. So it's reflexive when you're doing it to yourself or something. For example, the train stopped in the platform.
Exacto. El tren se detuvo.
En el andén.
En el andén.
Mm-hmm. Okay, right. So reflexive, it's doing it to itself or they're doing it to themselves.
Correcto.
Not you're doing it to something or something's doing it to something
else. No,
else.
Then it wouldn't be reflexive anymore.
Wouldn't be reflexive. Okay, excellent. What about this one? When you you're walking along and you get a shock and you...
Do you have to go like that?
Yes, absolutely. That's what I do.
That's, you could say, quedarse petrificado.
Quedarse petrificado. Petrified.
Petrified.
Ah, okay. Yeah.
That's usually with fear.
Yeah. Hmm. Which comes, it comes from being turned into stone, isn't it?
Uh-huh,
yeah.
Sí.
Petrificado. Yeah. All right. And if you were going to just bring yourself to a halt. So you're not really stopping like that, just bringing yourself to a halt. Would that be detenerse? Me detuve.
Yeah, me detuve.
Mm. Me paré.
Me paré.
Okay.
Did we write something down that I can't remember?
No. Just the difference between stopping and freezing with fear.
Oh, if you want to, like, if you stop like that, if you're walking and you suddenly stop and you don't move, you can say pararse en seco.
En seco. Mm. Dryly.
Dryly, sí. En seco, de...
Yeah.
Not moving.
Yeah. Okay. I hear that quite a lot for just stopping like suddenly.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. But not en seco doesn't mean frightened. It just means stopping suddenly, doesn't it?
Yes. But if you use quedarse petrificado, then that person is frightened.
So that's
what typically.
Quedarse. Me quedé petrificado.
Quedarse petrificado, sí.
Okay.
Or parar en seco if you're just stopping.
Okay. And then the last one, just to stop smoking, to stop eating sugar, things like that, that's...
Dejar de.
Dejar de. So how could you say, I really want to stop smoking?
realmente quiero dejar de fumar.
Okay. And last week I stopped eating sugar.
La semana pasada dejé de comer azúcar.
Perfecto. Qué bien hablas español. Choca. Bueno, eso es todo. We've covered all of the stops. And so we're going to stop. Vamos a detenernos.
Nos detenemos.
And we'll see you in the next one.
Nos vamos.
Y nos vemos. ¡Hasta luego!
¡Adiós!